standard 10 math chapter 14 statistics now any data is classified in two different parts, that is ungrouped data and grouped data. Now again, further this group data is classified in two parts. It is discrete and continuous. Now let me give an example. For ungrouped data, 5, 10, 20, 25, 37, 3, raw numbers are there. No grouping is there. So it is called ungrouped data. Now for discrete, we have Xi and Fi. Now what can be the discrete? Let me write down 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here 15, 10, 5, 2, 1. I can write here number of family and here number of child. Now, can I represent child in a fraction? 2.5 child. 1.2 child. Can I write them in a fraction? Can I write children in a fraction?
No,
sir. Tell me. Okay. Therefore, discrete means integer data. Data that cannot be shown in fraction form. Example I can give. Number of children. Number of mistakes. It cannot be in point, right? Not in fraction. Number of accidents. All these are discrete example. Example of discrete data. Clear? This point is clear to everyone? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, continuous data is again divided in two parts. Continuous data again divided in two parts. The first one is inclusive and the other is exclusive. The one which excludes the number is exclusive. One which includes the number is inclusive. Let's say class and frequency, FI, 0 to 9, 10 to 19, 20 to 29, 5, 15, 10, etc. And here exclusive is which has exclude the number, that is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. So here frequency is 5, 15 and 10. Now you can clearly see these are the lower boundary points. Lower boundary and upper boundary. lower boundary point and upper boundary point. Right? Lower boundary and upper boundary. Now you can see upper boundary of the previous class doesn't match with the lower boundary of the next class. That's why they are inclusive. What does it mean? Now if we convert this into exclusive, let me convert. If I convert minus 0.5 to 9.5, then 9.5 to 19.5. 0.5 is added to the upper boundary, 0.5 subtracted to the lower boundary, 19.5 to 29.5, right? So these are the conversions of class from inclusive to exclusive. Understand, I have already converted the upper boundary, 0.5 is added, 9 plus 0.5, 9.5, 19 plus 0.5, 19.5, 29 plus 0.5, 29.5. Same way I have subtracted 0.5 on the lower boundary. So this is conversion of inclusive to exclusive. Now this is exclusive. Why I am writing inclusive and exclusive, you can understand from this. Here 9 is included in the first class only. Boundary points are included in the class itself. And here boundary points are not included, they are excluded. 10 is considered in the next class. 10 is considered in the next class. Same way 20 is considered in the next class. Same way 30 is included in the next class. So this is exclusive data. Clear up to this point, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, first topic, mean. Now, formula to find mean. First method is considered as a direct method. Formula for direct method will be x bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. For x bar, we'll write symbol of mean in this way. X bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. Now sigma fi xi is equal to sum of product of observation and frequency. Sigma fi means sum of frequency. We can denote n also for that. Sum of frequency. First formula clear. Second is shortcut method. We call it assumed mean method. Assumed mean method. Formula for it is x bar is equal to a plus sigma fi di upon sigma fi. Now here a is equal to assumed mean? Di is equals to xi minus a. We can call it difference of observation and assumed mean, or we can call deviation. Deviation of observation and mean. FIDI or sigma FIDI is sum of frequency, sum of product of,
sir,
just a minute, frequency and DI. So this is FIDI, and sigma FI we have already explained, sum of frequency. Now next is step deviation method. Step deviation method. We popularly call it method of UI. Now, what is the formula for that? It is x bar is equals to a plus sigma fi ui upon sigma fi into h. A plus sigma fi ui upon sigma fi into h. Now let's write expression. Here a is assumed mean. Ui is equals to xi minus a upon h. Difference of observation and assumed mean divided by class length. S is equals to class length. And sigma fi ui is sum of product of frequency and UI. Frequency and UI. Now for this direct method is useful for discrete data. Assuming can be useful for discrete and continuous. Only discrete we can write, discrete data. And for step deviation is used for continuous data. And for short sum, we use ungrouped data. We use it for ungrouped data. Formula is X bar is equal to sigma Xi upon sigma Fi. We can call it N also. Sigma Xi upon sigma Fi that you are using since 9th standard. Sigma Xi, sum of observation. Sigma Fi, sum of frequency. Another method, short sum used will be, that will run later. For short sums, ungrouped data X bar is equal to sigma Xi upon sigma Fi. Second, mode. We call it symbolically Z. Use it in exercise 14.2. Now, formula. First, for ungrouped data, highest repetition of frequency. For example, 5, 10, 15, 10, 7, 2, 5, 10. These are your frequency. So you can see 10 is repeating for 3 times. Therefore, Z is equal to 10. No method is there. Just to write the highest frequency. Now I think it is there in 9th standard. Is it? For discrete data, Xi in line of highest Fi. For example, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10, 15, 17, 3, 2. Now here, highest Fi is 17. So your Z will be 2. Your Z will be 2. Now, third one is for continuous data, either inclusive or exclusive. Formula is same. Z is equals to L plus F1 minus F0 upon 2F1 minus F0 minus F2 into H. Now let's see. L is lower boundary point. point of highest frequency class. Then F1 highest FI, F0 above F1 and F2 below F1. These are the numbers or frequencies you have to remember for this formula. Now this is all about mode. Now third one is median. Symbolically we write M and we use it in exercise 14.3. Formula for ungrouped data. For ungrouped data and discrete data, both for both we have a same formula. If sigma fi is odd and if sigma fi is even, m is equals to n plus 1 by 2th observation, and if it is even, m is equals to n by 2th observation plus, let me write here, m is equals to n by 2th observation plus n by 2 plus 1 observation divided by 2. Very important this one. N by 2th observation plus n plus n by 2 plus 1th observation by 2. Now, for continuous data, m is equals to n by 2th observation class. And then m is equal to l plus n by 2 minus cf upon f into h. Again, let me describe. L is equal to lower boundary point of m class, that is median class. M class means median class. Then CF is cumulative frequency of previous class. F is equals to frequency of median class and H is equals to class length of median class. Class length of median class. Once again, L, lower boundary point of median class, CF, cumulative frequency of previous class of M class, frequency F, Fi of median class, and H, class length of median class. These are the formula for median. Now, formula shortcut Z is equals to 3M minus 2X bar. This is mode is equals to 3 into median minus 2 into mean. This value of mode is called approximate value of mode. Approximate value of mode.